Good morning. I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know for this Wednesday, April 7th. A Toms River family that was seeking an apology from Spirit Airlines over a mask incident that required all passengers to get off the plane didn't get that apology. The attorney for the couple had set the deadline for last night. Spirit simply issued a statement reiterating what they said before, that the issue was over the parents not wearing a mask, but they would like to open up a dialogue with the couple. No idea what's going to happen next. New Jersey is seeing among the highest COVID infection rates in the nation at a time when overall the number of infections are dropping nationwide. In fact, almost half of all infections in America are centered in just five states: New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Michigan, Florida. Just why is not clear. Some health experts are saying it's probably due to COVID mutations that are prevalent here. The UK variant certainly has been spreading in New Jersey. The level of restrictions doesn't seem to have anything to do with it. New Jersey, New York have among the toughest restrictions in the nation. Florida, Michigan, Pennsylvania do not. The rate of transmission has fallen in New Jersey slightly for another day, but still above one, meaning the outbreak is continuing to spread in the Garden State. Hospitalizations did take another tick up. New Jersey is on the verge of issuing almost 5 million vaccinations. We could surpass that 5 million mark perhaps by the end of this week. Vaccine supply is continuing to increase. But even though we'll hit the goal of 70% of the adult population being vaccinated well before Memorial Day, Governor Murphy still is not signaling that he is going to roll back any additional restrictions. Rutgers students and staff can begin registering on the Rutgers website for a vaccine. Clinics have been approved for the Camden, Newark, and New Brunswick campuses. Remember, all students will need to provide proof of vaccination before they return to the campus in the fall. As part of an effort to protect people who lost their jobs during this pandemic, Governor Murphy issued a moratorium on evictions for non-payment of rent. Well, a group of landlords have gotten together. They're suing the Murphy administration, claiming that that order is essentially illegal. New Jersey's budget is balanced in part by over $4 billion in emergency borrowing linked to revenue losses tied to the pandemic. Well, now the nonpartisan Office of Legislative Services says it is clear that borrowing simply wasn't needed. Tax collections are way ahead of projections, and even without the borrowing, the budget would be in balance. The Murphy administration still defending the borrowing of that money. Local lawmakers in Wayne are likely to adopt what could be the state's toughest ban on marijuana sales, just as the state prepares to set up the new marketplace for recreational weed. The Wayne Council is expected to approve a total ban on all sales, recreational and medicinal. A New Jersey man charged with a capital incursion last January is again asking a federal judge to let him out of prison. His attorney says Michael Hale Cusinelli is not charged with any violent acts, though he is facing multiple charges related to that incursion. Last month, federal prosecutors argued that Hale Cusinelli was a threat to the public as a Nazi sympathizer and a white supremacist. Mercer County Executive Brian Hughes says he is fit to govern, even if he might not be that great of a driver. Hughes is now admitting a third incident while he was driving. You'll remember that in 2017, there was an incident on the Pennsylvania Turnpike where he told police he thought he was racing in Paris. He now says on Nassau Street in Princeton, he scraped another vehicle, and he's now considering potentially giving up his county-issued vehicle. There have been a number of instances in New Jersey's waterways recently of dead fish washing up. State environmental officials are trying to figure out why. This includes the Raritan Bay, the Navesink, and Shrewsbury Rivers. They have preliminarily identified a bacteria that may be responsible for the fish kill. And if you like roller coasters, Great Adventure has got something for you coming up for their new season. On select days, Thursday and Friday nights in April and May, Six Flags will host Coaster Power Hours. These are special events celebrating the park's world-class roller coaster collection, including King de Ka, Nitro, El Toro. You can ride as often as you want. There'll be other special events happening in the park at the same time. You do have to register because attendance is limited. That's at sixflags.com/reserve. Got something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please remember to like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls and talking Jersey on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know for this Wednesday, April 7th. Have a great day.